reviewed the unit of work called Investigating Food and Fibres. It's about essentially farming and where we source our day-to-day products. I really enjoyed the teacher background at the beginning. I found that valuable. We've got lots of students in the class who come off of farms, and I don't have a farming background myself. So it was good to have that knowledge to help build on their current understanding. So I think we did a bit of a head count, and 8 out of 10 students live on farms currently. So their prior knowledge is pretty extensive, but it could be equally useful for city children as well, just knowing where things come from. Finding resources has been a bit of a time-consuming effort. We've trying to cover the cross-curriculum priorities as well and the general capabilities, keeping everything in mind. Having the online resources there was really valuable, especially to a small site like we are. We're not that well resourced. We can't just go to the library and pull out a certain book that some units of work expect you or assume that you'll have. I didn't really find the need to further research. What was provided with the e-tools and the games and the teacher background knowledge was sufficient to teach the unit, I felt. The activity that I enjoyed or found the most interesting was the table activity, where students would have a circle and they would draw all of the food that they eat in a day on that circle, and then we'd research where and how that food was produced. We look at the process of producing food items and clothing items from fibre, and we do go into design technology as well with what processes are followed, what machinery is used, what technologies are used for this production and how that's changed. They know about cattle, they know about sheep, they know about wheat, but the other industries like cotton, timber, several of the other foods that are produced, they don't have that knowledge of, and just seeing them open up their eyes and know that this industry is bigger than what they thought has been good to see. I found that it fit in well in the history and social studies area. With the background information that it gives, it shows how these industries do contribute to the Australian economy as well. Job opportunities within this industry, primary production, are huge. The amount of students at this site in particular that will possibly or probably end up working in these industries, it's great to open their eyes and show them that there's even more opportunities than they would have thought were possible.